Hello guys, you are welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to use OBS Studio. OBS simple means Open Broadcast Software. It's normally used for streaming. So today I'm going to show you how to use OBS Studio to record your computer screen. Let's get onto the computer so that I can show you how to use it. On your PC, you can use any of your favorite browser. So I'm using Google Chrome. Go ahead and search for obsproject.com/download. So you can scroll down to obsproject.com/download. Click on it. It will bring you to their page. You can see you can download for your Windows, Mac, depending on the operating system that you are using. So let's go ahead and click on download. So it will give you this dark box. You want to save? Yes. So now OBS is downloading. So after you download it, it will bring you this pop-up message to install it. So click on next. And again next to install it. Let's wait for a bit. Now we have OBS full install on our PC, so it's asking you to launch the OBS 26.1.1. So let's click on finish to launch the OBS. First time using OBS, this is how the interface look like. There's a lot of layers over here. We have files, edits, view, profile, scene collection, tool, and help. And down here too, we have a scene. We have sources. Sources is where the camera, audio, and everything is located. We have audio mixer. That is where you can control your audio, your desktop audio, and your mic, everything. You can control it. We have scene transition, and we have controls. We have start streaming. We have start recording, start virtual cameras, studio mode, settings. So let me show you something. Let's go to settings and go to output. So here we are going to choose where our project will be saved to. So this is recording path. Let's click on the browser. So let's create new file, new folder, and create OBS project. After it, then you click on select folder. So now we know where our project is going to save. Let's come down here, recording format. Let's click on it. You can choose MP4. You can choose any of this format that you want, but I prefer using the MKV, because if you choose the MP4, if in case the file deletes, you cannot get it again unless you do another video. But if you choose MKV, the file always remain on your PC, so you can convert it later. Back to our layer, let me show you how you can set up your recording scene. So let's click on the scene. You can see there's a plus button here. Click on it. This box will appear. You can type screen recorder. Then click on OK. When you finish creating, you will come to sources. You can see plus over here, minus, settings, up and down. So let's click on the plus button. When you press on the plus button, you will see duplicate, you see group, you will see window capture. Window capture means you are going to capture only the windows. Video capture, this means you are going to use only the webcam. We have text, we have media source, we have image, we have game capture. If you are playing game and you want to capture, this is where you will click. And we have display capture. This is what we are going to use for the screen recorder. So let's click on it. This dialog box will appear. You can change the name or you can maintain the name. So let's click on OK. So let's go to the settings. You can see display over here. If you are using multiple monitor, this is where you choose it from. So you can see another option over here, capture cursor. If you want to display the cursor when you are doing your recording, this is where you choose it, whether you take it or you off it. So let's click on OK. So now we have our recording set up. Let me show you another option if you want to bring your webcam when recording. So let's go to sources and click on plus button, then choose video capture device. So here we are going to choose the video capture device. There will be another dialog box. Let's click on OK. So now you can see my camera is now on. So if you are using additional camera, this is my laptop camera that I'm using. So that is it. If you have additional camera attached, it will also display here. So let's go down here and click on OK. So now this is our camera. We can also drag it on the screen. So let's make it small. So this is my camera. So I now have my recording screen and I now have another camera over here. If you don't want to use the camera when recording, you can go back to the sources and click on the video capture device and delete it. You can use the delete on the keyboard to delete it. You will see that dialog box over here, delete it. Then you delete it. So this is how it is done. If you still want to use the camera when recording your desktop, you can also bring it back again. Go to video capture device. Click on OK. So now your camera is back again. Let's click on OK. Let's make it small like this. So that is it. So now we have finished creating the sources for our recording. So let's go ahead to the controls and start record. So you can see at the down here, now our video is recording. So you can place the camera on any place that you want to use it. You can place it here. You can place it here. You can maintain it here. Let's go to, let's open our browser. Let's stop the recording. So this will come. Are you sure you want to stop recording? Yes. Let's go to file, show recording. So now this is our recording. Let's click on it and play it. Record. So you can see it down here. So now you can see this is my picture over here. This is me here. And this is the browser. So this is how the screen recording look like when you finish your project. So let's close the player and go back to OBS. So that is how it look like. If you don't want the camera to appear, you can go back to the sources and press on the manage button over here. It will automatically remove from your desktop. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoy watching this video. If you are new here, please, I have 2 videos over here. You can also watch them for me. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and hit on the notification bell icon for more updates. Thank you.